The New York Knicks are finally winning games and have fans going like this. Yeah, shocking, right? But the New York Knicks are on an 8-game winning streak and are having their first winning season in over 7 years and are currently putting the league on notice and are already locked in for the playoffs. In today's video, we'll discuss on how the New York Knicks have been completely transformed and have become a winning organization. But before we get onto the video, please make sure to subscribe. We're so close to 5,000 subscribers, less than 40 away. So hit that subscribe button so you can join the family and we could hit 5,000 subscribers. Make sure to hit that like button. Dropping a like helps out YouTube algorithm a lot. And with all that being said, let's get right into the video. The New York Knicks are currently sitting at the fourth spot in the West right now with a 33-win and 27-loss record. And like I said again, are having their first winning season since the past 7 years and are currently on an 8-game winning streak. I can't believe I'm saying this about the Knicks, but man, they're having an amazing season. But the real question is, what makes the New York Knicks so good? To start off, led by their all-star Julius Randle, who is averaging 23.9 points, 10.5 rebounds, and 6.1 assists per game, Julius Randle has been unusual self, being a strong player, getting through the paint, and has a decent three-point shot, and is honestly the leader of the team and is a favorite to win the Most Improved Player of the Year, as Julius Randle has completely been a new player, and it seems like he loves the Knicks. It's his own team, he's the leader of this team, and it truly shows what he has been doing on the court. Next, we have RJ Barrett, the second-year player out of Duke, who is having a way better year than his rookie year, as most could say his rookie year was a little bit of a letdown and a disappointment. But in his second year, RJ Barrett is having a breakout year, averaging 17.4 points, 5.6 rebounds, and 2.9 assists per game. And like I said again, he's proving himself that he's a lethal scorer who can get to the basket anytime. He's proven that he can score from all three levels, and it's just showing the young gun has some true potential in him, and I really think that he can be a future leader of this team as well. As this New York Knicks team is a fully complete team. It has many nice young pieces, such as the breakout rookie Emmanuel Quickly. Nobody expected this out of EQ, but he reminds me of a young Donovan Mitchell, even though Mitchell is pretty young right now, but he is in the category of rookie of the year. And EQ provides great energy off the bench and brings a spark to this team with his great three-point shooting and jump shot. You know, Emmanuel Quickly is one of those rookies where you just know he's gonna have an amazing and long career in the NBA. A lot of it came to a shock. Nobody expected him to be this good, but he's been providing some nice minutes off the bench for this Knicks team, providing some nice scoring and depth to this team. Then obviously, it might have came to a surprise, the New York Knicks acquired Derrick Rose once again, and he's having an amazing year with the Knicks so far. Again, another smart move by the Knicks organization. D. Rose has been providing great minutes off the bench, and again, has shown that he's still a good playmaker and scorer in this league today. He's averaging 13.4 points per game, and again, he's a veteran, he has experience in the playoffs, so he's going to be a great mentor to some of these young guys on this Knicks team, and especially the new rookies. To name some other nice pieces, they also have Reggie Bullock, who again is a great three-point shooter. He really doesn't provide much out of the three-point shot, but again, the New York Knicks are a team who desperately need three-point shooting, and that's exactly what Bullock does. He sits in the corner and he could shoot the three ball very, very easily again, so he's a great young piece to this team, as he still has many nice years ahead of him, and the potential is bright for Reggie Bullock and the New York Knicks. Knicks also acquired Nerlens Noel, Alfred Payton, and again, there's still some nice young pieces that add to this team's core and depth, and they just make this team a nice fit overall. But in my opinion, this New York Knicks team is well built, and the chemistry really seems to be forming over there in New York, and they're really something to not be slept on and to be taking seriously, especially in the playoffs, as I can even see them getting out of the first round and surprising a lot of folks over there in New York. This last 8-game stretch for the Knicks has been huge as they are currently on an 8-game winning streak, and it's not against bum teams. In their winning streak, they have beat out the likes of the Grizzlies, Raptors, LA Lakers, Pelicans, Mavericks, Pelicans again, Hornets, and then recently the Hawks yesterday in overtime, where the Knicks battled it out and finally won. And man, it's just so shocking to see the Knicks winning. I know I've said this, but I can't believe it, man, because the Knicks have been so bad in the past years. The biggest key part people forget about the New York Knicks is the amount of times that they had to change coaches within the past 10 years. I'm gonna name some of them: Mike D'Antoni, Mike Woodson, Derek Fisher, Kurt Rambis, Jeff Hornack, David Fizdale, and Mike Miller recently, and finally they acquired Tom Thibodeau in 2020, and he's been the answer to this Knicks team and is doing a decent job coaching this team and has completely transformed them. He's been the best to do it out of the last 10 coaches. But the real question is going to be in the playoffs. Can the Knicks make some damage in the playoffs? In my personal opinion, I think the Knicks can beat the first round and can make it to the second round, but I don't see them going any further because they still need some more pieces in the offseason, and I hope that they can acquire them. But again, the Knicks are heading in the right step, and it's just a very positive and bright sign, and I feel really, really happy for all you Knicks fans watching this video right now. I know you had to deal with a bad past decade, but trust me, brighter days are only ahead and the worst is all behind. But this is going to end off the video. Thank you guys for all watching. Comment down below your thoughts on this New York Knicks team, and what do you guys think the future is? Do you guys think that they're going to just be a first round exit, or can they actually make a decently deep playoff push? Comment down below what other things I missed, if I missed anything about the Knicks. Comment down below anything. I just want to get to hear your guys' thoughts and opinions. Make sure to hit that like button. Dropping a like helps a lot, man. And like I said again, we're so close to 5,000 subscribers. I'm pretty sure we're less than 40 away right now. And that's been one of my biggest goals on this channel. And it's thanks to all of you guys. One more thing. Comment down below any future video ideas. I'm trying to make videos you guys like, and it really seems like it's working. You know, a lot of these videos I do, it's a lot of your guys' video ideas. So I have to give props to you guys. And with all that being said, I know I've been talking for a while now. I'm out. Peace.